Relief knowing that he died doing what he loved so much.
A spokesperson for the Gfeller family sits down with us for an exclusive interview on what was supposed to be Matthew's first day at Reynolds High School. Our Big Story team coverage continues now with more reaction to the tragic death of sophomore linebacker Matthew Gfeller, who passed away after an injury in Friday night's football game. Our Kenny Beck sat down exclusively with a Gfeller family spokesperson, and he joins us now live outside of R.J. Reynolds High School with that story. Kenny?
Yeah, Cameron, Mary Beth Cross says the Gfellers, considering what they've been through in the last 72 hours, are doing about as well as they possibly can, considering it was just 3 days ago they were all set to watch their youngest boy play his first ever varsity football game, and now he's no longer with them.
Bob Gfeller, the father, went down first, and I guess the first time I realized it was a little bit different was that he frantically motioned for the mother to come down on the field.
Mary Beth Cross was sitting with Matthew Gfeller's parents Friday night at Deaton Thompson Stadium when the 15-year-old suffered a brain injury that ultimately claimed his life.
The doctor explained it like this: there's no way to explain it.
At first, she says everyone thought Matthew suffered a spinal cord injury. When a CAT scan revealed no damage, doctors operated on his brain to reduce swelling, and for a brief while, things were looking okay.
About 2 o'clock in the morning.
Saturday
morning, we got a call that the surgery was not going well. And so my husband and I went back to the hospital, and it was pretty clear at that point he could not be saved.
Matthew was taken off life support at 9 o'clock that night.
He felt no pain. He did not suffer.
Even though he never regained consciousness after that block in the fourth quarter, Cross says he remained alive, off life support for almost 4 hours before finally passing away Sunday at about 1 a.m.
His body was just so strong and healthy, it just took a little longer than they anticipated.
Cross says the loss of Matthew has definitely sunk in for the Gfeller family.
They are great people who have a very strong faith and a very strong family and a very strong group of friends. It is devastating to all of us who love them because they are such great people.
Through their grief, Cross says the thought his parents keep coming back to is one that brings everyone who knew this young man great comfort. Matthew Allen Gfeller died doing what he loved.
This is a child who trained daily, and there are a list of goals on his door. The first one is to start on the football team at Reynolds High School, and he did.
Cameron, Mary Beth Cross told me, in addition to that interview that you just saw, that doctors told the Gfeller family the hit, the block, which injured their boy, was perfectly legal and it was perfectly clean. It was one of those freak things because of where he got blocked. It was right in this area between his shoulders underneath of his chin that somehow, by some freak, horrible accident, caused this immediate and catastrophic injury.
And Kenny, understand, in just a remarkable display of courage and kindness, the Gfellers met with the player from Page High School who was involved in the play in which their son was injured.
That's correct. They met with not just the player from Page, but his entire family yesterday. We don't have any details of that. We're told this was a very private discussion between the two families, which unfortunately are now bound together forever through these horrible events. We also wanted to make sure that the Gfellers get this information out. They wanted to thank very much the schools, their hospitals, their churches, and also all of Matthew's teammates and friends here at R.J. Reynolds High School.
And certainly our prayers going out to them tonight. Thank you, Kenny. Kenny Beck, live at R.J.